Now we will see list item, how to create the list item. In the author table, we are changing nationality column as a list item. The property sheet, select item type as list item. After, go to element in list and select the two elements, because as per our database, there is two values are there, Indian and Oman. So that's why we are giving Indian and Oman. This list element is related to runtime. Runtime, how in the list item values are appear. This value only appear in the runtime. This value is related to database. Suppose once you select Indian, it will go and save the Indian. If I select Omani, it will go and select the Omani. For example, here by default, I am selecting as, for example, Indian, Omani, and then I am selecting American. American value I am selecting, but I will place list to defy. I am not change the value. Here only I am changing the value. Now you can understand, this list of element is available, display in the runtime. This list item value is related to our database. Whatever the value coming here, it should save in your database. Now I said okay. Then I will compile it and run the thing. So the list items are very useful. Whenever we have more values, no need to type or remember the values. So list item is very useful for me while creating the, that is the purpose of the list item. So now we will see how list item is working in the. So the list item values depend upon how many number of values available in the database. For example, here in the database we have two values, that's why we get three values. Third value just to try it for the trial base, how, what error is coming, how it is working for the doing the trial. Now we can see, I'll execute this particular form, how it is working the execute. You can see here, next record I am going, second record is coming. Now you can see, Indian, Omani, American is coming. So now I will change this as a American. What value changing? Now I will change it to American. The second value, Dr. Amal value, I will change as American. Then I will see. Then I will save the value here. One transaction complete, one record. So now we change Omani to American. Now we will go and see our SQL database, what are the values are coming. Suppose I will give the values. Now I will select the values here. Then I will go and select the values here. See, list 25 is coming. Why? Because here in the property sheet we given American. If I select American in the runtime, the value to be stored in the database is right. So that's why it is related to database, it is related to runtime. Now I will do one thing. I will change Omani to list 25. I will change this list 23, but here I will have keep the value as it is, Oman. So this list 23 will appear in the runtime, but the value stored in the database is Oman. Now I give OK. Again I will compile. Again I will run the form. You can see how values are coming. So now I will go. I'll check my database, what are the values are available now. So now what are the values are available currently? Currently Indian and list 25 is available. I want to change this value to be again Omani. So you can clearly understand what is the difference between list of element and list of value. That's why we are doing now. So now I will run this particular execute query. Now you can see next one, you can see American is coming. Now you can see list 23 is coming, because we given here why list 23 is coming. Here we are given list 23, that's why it is coming in the runtime list 23. So now I will select list 23. Again I will save the form. You see here in the status bar transaction complete, one record complete. Now I will go and check my database. You can see my database, what are the values. So this is what the list item. So this is the end of the list item. What in the list item is nothing but go to the property sheet, change the item type as a list item, go to element of list and give the list element. This is related to runtime. It will appear how the value should appear in the runtime list items. The list item value is connected with your databases. Suppose it is wrong, it won't. For example, here I am giving Indian, but I will give India. Now I will give the value India here. Indian, but I will give the value India here. I'll give OK here. But if you see, go and see, run again and compile the form. Now you see what the first record is coming. First record, what is the first record? How it will appear in the first record? You can see in that, because we changed the value in the database item is a India, but there is no value database called India. Indian is there, Omani is there. This is what the values are available in the database. Currently available values are this one. For example, now I will execute. List 23 is coming, Indian is coming, but India will store in the, now I have stored the Dr. Amal, but no first value. You can see the first value, first record is not coming because second record only available. First record won't come. Why? Because it is not matching. Database value is not matching. That's why it will start with second value, not with the first value. This is a run. You can't able to see the record. If this item, the display item, this database item is not matching, which record is matching? The first record is matching. So you can't able to see the author number 1. Author number 1 value you can't able to see in the runtime. Again I will execute, I'll check. It won't come in the first record. It will come only in the second record. So first record won't come because the values are not matching. That's why it won't display in the runtime. This runtime error will come here. It won't give in the compilation, but in runtime the record won't display. This is the end of the session for the list item.